crocus. Other seeds fell on good soil and brought forth green. Someone gave me 2 seeds of a special variety of drumstick tree. In turn, I gave 1 to a friend. My seed sprouted and the tree yielded some 500 drumsticks in the first crop alone. Sadly, my friend's seed was gobbled by a chicken. The seed is a fertile image even for those who are not farmers. What miracle keeps a tiny seed alive in the dark soil? Jesus points to the conditions that make his words life-giving. Perhaps distractions make it difficult for us to read and ponder God's word. Perhaps we do not water our understanding with meditation. We prattle, but fail to really listen. Or could the thorns be sinful attitudes, bad habits, and the absence of prayer? How fortunate were the disciples to hear Jesus in person. What if I had lived in the time of Christ? Would I have been receptive to his call, or as lazy and selfish as I am today? It is comforting to remember that God's grace is ever present and innumerable persons through the ages fine-tuned their inner ear and heard the voice of God. These were the saints, like Saint Augustine, attentive to the soil of their lives. The precious seed yielded rich fruit at its appointed time. Fruit. Do I tend the soil of my life by scripture reading, contemplations, and prayer so that God's word yields rich fruit in and through me?